Hello and welcome back. This is Sherry with Full Armor of God. And today I wanted to come on here and tell you about a dream that I had this morning. I had a dream upon awakening in my bedroom. I was dreaming that I was waking up out of my sleep. And it was in like a shadowy light, like around sunrise. And my grandmother, who had passed away probably about 30 years ago now, she was in the room with me, and she was reading out of the Bible. And it seemed like we were sitting on the bed, and I was just waking up from out of my slumber. And suddenly, there was a bright light that was shown from the outside into my bedroom window. And I looked out of the window and saw Jesus in a blue and white robe coming through the clouds. Then I awoke for real and looked at the clock, and it was 6:52 a.m. this morning. So I was led to John chapter 6, verse 52, and I'm just going to read 52 through 58 so you can get the idea of what this Bible verse is all about. It says, "The Jews therefore strove among themselves, saying, 'How can this man give us his flesh to eat?' Then Jesus said unto them, 'Verily, verily, I say unto you, except ye eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, ye have no life in you. Whoso eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood hath eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. For my flesh is meat indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He that eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood dwelleth in me, and I in him. As the living Father has sent me, and I live by the Father, so he that eateth me, even he shall live by me. This is that bread which came down from heaven, not as your fathers did eat manna and are dead. He that eateth of this bread shall live forever.'" So it's symbolic, I believe. I was raised Catholic. But now I go to a Pentecostal church, so I just believe in Jesus. So wherever the Holy Spirit leads me, that's where I go. So, but I believe this is symbolic of communion, the sacrament of communion, Holy Communion, eating the bread and blood. And I was also led to the book of Isaiah because I looked up the number 652. Remember, that was the time it was when I woke up. And I found in Strong's Concordance in the Greek, it says the meaning of the word is, actually it's apostolos, which means a messenger, one sent on a mission, an apostle. And under the usage, it says a messenger, envoy, delegate, one commissioned by another to represent him in some way, especially a man sent out by Jesus Christ himself to preach the gospel, an apostle. And I believe it also could be a representation of the Father sending Jesus down to earth. And in the Hebrew, it's pronounced Ophel, and it's definition is darkness, gloom. And if you look further down, I was led to Isaiah chapter 29, verse 18. Let me read that for you. It says, "And in that day shall the deaf hear the words of the book, and the eyes of the blind shall see out of obscurity and out of darkness." So to me, I believe that this dream I had was a rapture dream. And I awoke at that time because that scripture is the scripture that is John chapter 6, verse 52, where the Jews were wondering how this man can give us his flesh to eat. So they were doubting who he was. And I believe that's symbolic also today of some people that are the lost people who aren't really sure who Jesus is, and they don't believe that he can save you. But I believe that he will be saving us at the very exact moment when we need save the most. And that scripture, like I read, Isaiah 29:18, it says, "In that day shall the deaf hear the words of the book, and the eyes of the blind shall see out of obscurity and out of darkness." So they will see him and believe, and those who do believe will be saved out of the darkness. So whatever this darkness event is that's going to take place, I believe we're going to be snatched away right out of it. He's going to be our savior, and he's going to catch us out of danger or out of harm's way just in the nick of time. And I believe that's what this representation of this rapture dream that I had today is all about, is showing that Jesus will come right on time. And my grandmother was a very devout, she was Catholic. I was raised Roman Catholic, and she was always praying the rosary. So I believe that is showing the faithful Christians who are the believers that are hoping that he will be coming any moment, that this dream also is a dream that will give you some encouragement that he is coming very soon, because I did have that dream today. So I thought I would come on today and tell you this dream so that it would give you some hope and understanding about what the message of the dream meant and the time that I saw and what the representation of that was, of some people who don't understand who Jesus is and that he is our savior and he is his body and blood are the living sacrifice that he gave up when he was crucified on the cross. So this is the message for today. I hope it encourages you. I hope that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ will be coming and he will rescue us just when we need him the most. And may God bless you.